discussion of the front of the leg. It is called the extensor compartment of the lower limb or leg extensor compartment. The cutaneous distribution on the medial side, there is directly the, you can see the scene of the tibia, and the skin over the scene of the tibia, mainly it is innervated by the, this is a saphenous nerve. It is the longest cutaneous nerve of the body, which is the branch of the posterior division of the femoral nerve, and along with the great saphenous vein, anterior to the great saphenous vein throughout. The laterally, the cutaneous distribution here on the upper and lateral side, it is the lateral branch of the lateral cutaneous nerve of the calf. It is a branch of the common peroneal, and the lower part, the skin over the leg on the lateral aspect, as well as the dorsum of the foot, the skin which is innervated by the superficial peroneal nerve. So this is the superficial peroneal nerve which supplies the skin over the dorsum of the foot, except the clap between the great toe and the second toes. This area, which is the skin distribution by the deep peroneal nerve, remaining all of the dorsum of the foot, the skin innervated by the superficial peroneal nerve, as well as the skin of the lower part of the lateral side of the leg, which is innervated by the superficial peroneal nerve. So this is about to the cutaneous distribution. And the muscles of the front of the leg, extensor compartment of the leg, at the level of the between the two malleoli, this is a medial malleolus and this is the lateral malleolus. Medial malleolus lies the medially, there is a tibial bone, and laterally by the fibular bones. So in between there is a tendon. The, you have to remember, talented husbands are never dear person. T means this is the tibialis anterior. It is the first muscle on the medial aspect. The muscle which is goes to the great toe, it is the extensor ellipsis longus. After that, this is the anterior tibial artery. Here you can see, this is the anterior tibial artery, you can see. And along with the vena cavitans, and there is a deep peroneal nerve. This is the deep peroneal nerve. And the extensor digitorum longus and peroneus tertius. These are the muscles and now an artery which is lies inside the anterior compartment of the leg. All this muscle, extensor tibialis anterior, extensor ellipsis longus, extensor digitorum and peroneus tertius, as well as you can see, this is a deep muscles, very just small muscles, lies extensor ellipsis brevis and extensor digitorum brevis, both are the innervated by the deep peroneal nerve. So all the muscles of the extensor compartment which is innervated by the deep peroneal nerve. Now I will discuss about the first muscles. This is the extensor tibialis anterior. Tibialis anterior, which is arise from the ear, this is a lateral surface. You can see here, this is the lateral surface of the tibia, upper two-third part. It gives the origin of the tibialis anterior, and it is inserted on the medial cuneiform and base of the first metatarsal bone. So it is an insertion of the tibialis anterior. Extensor ellipsis longus, extensor ellipsis longus, which is arise from the extensor ellipsis longus. This extensor ellipsis longus, which is arise from the fibula on the posterior half of the middle two-fourth, posterior half of the middle two-fourth of the medial surface of the shaft of the fibula, it gives the origin of the extensor ellipsis longus, and it is inserted on the base of the dorsal surface of the distal phalanx of the great toe. Extensor digitorum longus, extensor digitorum longus, which arises from the lateral condyle of the tibia. This is the lateral condyle of the tibia. Medial surface of the shaft of the medial surface of the shaft of the middle one fourth, middle two fourth of the anterior half of the anterior half of the middle two-fourth of the medial surface of the shaft of the fibula, You have to remember the medial surface of the shaft of the fibula, it is very narrow, but even though it is divided into the two parts, anterior and posterior parts, and anterior part, it gives the origin of the extensor digitorum longus, and posterior part, it gives the origin of the extensor hallucis longus. But the extensor digitorum longus, which is longer and it is also arise from the lateral condyle of the tibia, and it is divided into the core tendon and the core slip, which is goes inside the all core tendon, and it is inserted on the base of the dorsal surface of the base of the second to fourth toes, and along with it there is a laterally joining of the fiber of the extensor digitorum brevis and extensor digitorum brevis. This is the fiber of the extensor digitorum brevis, which is joined on the lateral aspect, and it makes the dorsal digital expansion, and it is inserted on the base of the distal phalanx, base of the distal phalanx of the second, third and fourth distal phalanx. It is an insertion of the extensor digitorum longus, as well as the slip, which is also goes to the little finger, it is also inserted on the base of the distal phalanx. The peroneus tertius, which is it arises from the lower one fourth of the medial surface, of the shaft of the fibula, and inserted on the base of the distal phalanx on the dorsal surface of the little finger. So it is not distal finger, but it is on the base of the fifth metatarsal bones. Base of the fifth metatarsal bone, there is an insertion of the peroneus tertius muscles. So this is about to the extensor muscles, and this is the extensor digitorum brevis. Here you can see this muscle, which is the extensor digitorum brevis. This extensor digitorum brevis, which arises from the anterior part of the superior surface of the calcaneum. So anterior part of the superior surface, this is the calcaneum, this bone, and its superior surface, it gives the origin of the extensor digitorum brevis, and it is inserted, it divide into the three slip, and it is laterally attached to the tendon of the extensor digitorum longus, and it is makes the dorsal digital expansion. So all these muscles, which is innervated by the deep peroneal nerve, here you can see this deep peroneal nerve. This is the deep peroneal nerve, which gives the branches to the, following muscles, to the extensor hallucis longus. It gives branches to the extensor digitorum longus. So it gives the all the muscles of the extensor compartment, it gives the branches by the deep peroneal nerve. So this is the deep peroneal nerve. Now we will discuss about the anterior tibial artery. Here you can see this is the anterior tibial artery. This anterior tibial artery, it is the smaller terminal branch of the popliteal artery. At the lower angle of the popliteal fossa, it divides into the anterior tibial artery and posterior tibial artery. Anterior tibial artery, which is passes front side, it comes anteriorly between the tibia and fibula on the above to the introcious membrane, it comes into the anterior compartment. Initially, it lies between the tibialis anterior and extensor digitorum longus. Into the middle, it lies between the extensor tibialis anterior and extensor hallucis longus. Here you can see this is the anterior tibial artery and deep peroneal nerve. And into the lower part, it lies between the extensor hallucis longus and extensor digitorum longus. And The anterior artery, it gives the just initially into the upper part. Here we cannot see, but it gives the anterior tibial recurrent and posterior tibial recurrent. It gives the muscular branches, and it at the level of between the two malleoli, here you can see it gives the medial and lateral malleolar branches. Here you can see this is the medial malleolar, and over the lateral side, lateral malleolar branches, and it become continuous as a dorsalis pedis artery inside the dorsum of the foot between the two malleoli. It continues as a dorsalis pedis artery. This is the lateral malleolar branch, and this one is the medial malleolar branch. So, anterior artery, it is always along with the deep peroneal nerve, but the deep peroneal nerve, it lies into the upper one third part. It lies lateral to the anterior artery. Deep peroneal nerve into the middle one third, it lies anterior to the anterior artery, and again into the lower one third, it is deep peroneal nerve lies lateral to the anterior artery. So deep peroneal nerve, it is hesitate to cross the anterior artery, only into the middle one third, which only remain anterior to the deep peroneal nerve, remain anterior to the anterior tibial artery. Deep peroneal nerve remain anterior to the deep peroneal nerve, it lies anterior to the anterior tibial artery into the middle one third part. Remaining both the part, upper one third and lower one third part, deep peroneal nerve lies lateral to the anterior tibial artery. So this is about to the front of the leg and muscles of the front of the leg.